Okay, starting off, we've got this work object that's got all of my jobs in it. Very cool. And then we come down to the bottom here and we find the locationizer function. Locationizer is taking in the work object from above, and let's take a look inside of it. We start off by initializing a new array, which in this case is called location array, and it starts off empty. And then we've got a for in loop. This for in loop is going to iterate over every job within workObject.jobs. So remember, workObject is the object that we have up here, it's being passed in, and we're going to iterate through all of the jobs in it. For each of the new jobs, we're going to create a variable, and don't worry, it's going to get overwritten every time we run through this loop. The variable is called newLocation, and we're going to set it equal to the location of each job. So let's break this down a little bit. We've got the work object, and then within the work object, we've got the jobs array. And now, because of the for in loop, we've got the index of each job within the jobs array within the work object. And then for each job, we want the location. So we're just going to use dot notation to get the location. Once we have each location, we're going to push them using the dot push array method. So we'll start off with the name of the array that we want to return later, and we'll do dot push with new location as the parameter. Once this for loop is finished, we're going to return the location array, which we created earlier. All right, let's go ahead and see if this works. I will come down here, and let's console.log locationizer, and we'll pass in the work object from above. And if all goes well, we should see an array of the locations where I've worked. We'll hit test run, scroll down, and there we go. The log says that I've worked in Mountain View, Seattle, and I've had two jobs in Nashville.